that's me.
Yeah, when I shut off. I was suffering with boom.
There you go. All right, everybody, welcome into the semifinals of the Kings of Vegas event. We have Team Peak, who was 3-0 against Distinct Framework, who got in a very weird way. They were 1-0-2 with two ties on the day. So they squeaked into the four seed with 4 points. So we have a matchup of the Behemoths today. Distinct Framework did win the event last year. Peak was the number one seed coming in the round robin last year. So we're going to see how this plays out. Any words from El Presidente here? No? All right, we are going to go to a brief commercial and we'll be back in 1 minute 55 seconds with the start of the game.
Send it an email form so everybody can see it. We're not everybody can see it. It's probably going to be the first second. It's better if you guys go.
Yeah. I'm going live, Brokey.
Okay, guys, here we are. The semifinals, number one of the Kings of 4-on-4. Here we go. Peak in yellow, Distinct Frameworks in black, and we got a goaltender battle over here. We got Rael Cormier for Distinct Frameworks against Matt the Animal Lovies for Peak. Thank you. Peak with some pressure early. Stop by Cormier. Peak again shot. Big save by Real. 0-0. 30 seconds in. Period number one. Framework, Brad Foot over shot, saved by Lovies. McCann dish up. Brogy, who's 13 on yellow? Yeah, right there. Yeah, I thought so. Calm game here so far. Both teams feeling each other out. Foot coming down the wing. Tripped up by a Peak player. Hooked up. Down low. Thank you. 1-0 peak. Shot that squeaks in between the blocker and the body of Cormier. And the number one seed takes a 1-0 lead in the first period. Big collision there at the front of the net. And McCann with a nice pass over to 10. 10 coming down. What a goal. He puts in a Cormier skate. That is 2-0 peak. Number 10, I believe, is second of the game here. Delayed penalty call coming against Peak on the hook. Framers looking to capitalize. McDonald comes in. High shot off Lovey. McDonald again. Up high and out. Peaks going to the power play with 3 minutes left in the first period. Face off coming outside. And Brody Moore scoring off. Well, floods it here. And he blocks a shot. Bimo laying the body on the line here. And cleared by Morrison. Thank you. Staying on by Sparky. He reloads up high. He wants it again, looking for the one-timer. Sparky up high and wide. Sparky crossbar. Distinct Frameworks pushing Sparky again. Looks like Austin Matthews out here, just firing bullets in the net. Peak able to clear, relieve some pressure. 120 left in the first. That squeaks by Captain Homie. Hey, Brogy. Brogy.
Whatever team loses the 11 game will probably have to clear the room, right? Quickly. And then, not quickly, but...
Seconds left in the first period. Riley Steves goes back for it for Frameworks. Passed up. Number 11 coming down the wing. McCann with a break, but just not enough time. After one period here in Trenton, it is Peak 2, Distinct Framework 0. We'll be back after this brief commercial break. Back here for period two action, ladies and gentlemen. Peak breaking out 1-on-3. Play. 2-0 Peak, 1 minute in the second period here. Face off in the Peak zone. Distinct Framework looking to put one on the board and cut the lead in half here. Thank you. Framework steps up behind the net. Only a million people watching. Peek able to clear it. Here comes Fargie coming in. Thank you. McCann with a beauty. 3-0 peak, Devin McCann. .30 to go in the second, 3-0 peak. They are looking to advance to the finals to take on either the 2-seed CBY Soligier or the Quinney West Demons. That broke the ice, ladies. That broke the glass, ladies and gentlemen. We'll have a quick delay here and see what we can do to fix this. We'll be right back. We'll figure out what we're going to do here. And
that's a small box.
Thank you.
weird.
Thank you. some swing.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back. They have fixed the glass here. So we are about to begin the third period. It is 3-0 for Peak. And we will begin shortly here. We will be back by this brief commercial break. And then the game should resume. Sarge Lane Jones, appears there still is an issue with the ice. We may have to flood here, so we'll give it a break.
Amazing!
Hey, don't break another pane! Oh, a big case of pints right here.
They must have heard Jake Evans just got a big case.
Hey, Bebo! Bebo! Hey!
Hey!
I'm glad you won it!
Maybe I should get my own belt made.
Jam. Say jam on it. Be the champ.
That's the Rock. I'm the world's champ.
Somebody else say broke news flying upstairs. Oh man, WrestleMania's on! Delicious does. Did they already empty the fridge up there?
Huh?
Did they already empty the fridge up there?
Awesome.
What?
Well, because I know that case was in the fucking fridge.
I see it's in there. It's in a box.
No, it's all locked.
Is it locked?
Yeah. That's what I said. Yeah, there's no beer slate because I tried to open the door to keep it out.
Oh, they probably charge it.
So like I've probably seen 2,000 hockey games. I don't think I've ever seen a glass break like that.
How did it break?
Man, it was like a little wrist shot, but it hit like the top right corner and just fucking cracked. Like it just hit it weird. And...
So nothing's open up there. It's all locked up.
No, they locked it up. Yeah.
So it's out of the fridge?
Yeah, yeah. Apparently there's like a birthday party there today or something later on.
Did you grab the money last night?
Yeah, Brokey did.
Oh,
did he? I literally texted him like, man, like, we forgot that money there, didn't we?
I was laying in bed, I was like, did Andy grab it?
As soon as I got home, I sat down, I was like, oh, the money. Of course, fucking Chisel over here, like, oh, I got it, don't worry.
All right, guys, we are back live after a small intermission break from broken equipment out there on the ice. Guys, here we go, back into the action. It is 3-0. You beat over Framework with the Canada Figure 3 on your way. Big taste of a little bit of scrum behind the board for the semifinal game. Framework takes it out. Gets it out, definitely does get in the way. Still goes in. Oh, offside the call. 17 still out there trying to sell it. To ensure that the ref knows that he was outside.
We're going
to
zoom in. Dougie looks like he's got it over there. So.
That's all we could ask for today. I am JM. We are here all day today in the beautiful city of Trenton. 16 degrees. Got to watch a beautiful military parade today, which is always good. Outside the arena. Number 8 takes it in 4 feet. We want to save both the goalie and we'll just let it slide here today. Score right now is 3-0 peak over Framers in the semifinal game. 14 minutes left to go in the third period. Blum, how's your day going so far, my friend?
Oh, we're doing good. We got the glass situation resolved, JM. So a little stress reliever there, but no, day's going great. Peaks came out on fire this morning. I know you missed the first period here, but they came out hot. Devin McCann scored a beauty early to make it 3-0, and then Framework's really struggling here. I think they're down two of their top guys. Brody Butts got kicked out last night for a little scrap, and they're missing Lucas Hooley, who's trying to haul his butt back down from Toronto for the finals, but they need to get through this one, JM, and exactly they got a hill to climb here.
And like I was saying yesterday on yesterday's broadcast, I know that you want to be playing for Vegas, but you want to make sure you're going to help your team get to Vegas. So the Canadians last night was up to all four. You'll take your seat, now hopefully you can come back and get it up here in the third. Framers does have the puck, gets it out into the neutral zone, off his skate, comes in, across the blue line, number 10 out there, 19's opening the slot, backhand pass to number 11, number 11 just outside of it. Number 9 takes the puck forward, Pete, taking it around. Framework, he's got two guys on the back, trying to get the puck out. Puck is out, Framework does come back to play the puck, but the neutral zone. Back into the offensive zone off Pete. Pete gets the puck, passes it, oh, just missed. 16 has the puck on the half wall, gets it behind the net, number 7, puck's intercepted by Framework, trying to get it out, 19, stick hammer in front of his goal, never a good sign, wheels the puck around, looking for somebody, drops it off to his team partner, busts the ice, into the neutral zone. Pete gets possession of the puck, D pass in their own zone, just gets it up to the road. Pete coming in, number 10, all the way, loses hand on the puck. Framework gets the puck up. Then again, intercepted by Pete, steps it into the zone over a line change. 12 minutes left to go in the third period. Oh, pressure breakaway, number 9 has the puck, Framework, but it was something to pass it to.
comes around the boards. Pink picks up the puck. 16, trying to get it out. And icing will be done. 11 minutes and 40 seconds left to go here in the third period. On this beautiful day here, we are at the Kings of Vegas sweepstakes today. So come on out and support. Support was yesterday, was fantastic. Great to see all the family and friends come out, watch the games. Great game they played here yesterday. He gets the puck, takes it out, gets it into the zone, number two, does play the puck, passes up front to three with a little tip, goalie stands tall. Kramer's looking to clear the puck, plays it out in the neutral zone. Number seven, give him chase. Picks the puck at number five, the defenseman. Number two has the puck in his face, seven has it again. Seven comes around, drops off to his teammate. Takes the shot, and it just puddles off into the corner. 77 out there to give help for Kramer. Had a great tournament so far this week. Oh, penalty being called. Looking for a penalty call here from the ref.
Maddie. Wanna hold this for a few minutes? I'm just gonna talk to that other team and
playing 11. A few minutes for Plucking. Goschek. Call us 2 minutes for Goschek. Welcome to the booth by our great color technician, Daniel LeBlanc. Always great to have you here. Pink wins the game now. Gets the puck out. Number three has a 4-3 in the neutral zone. Takes the puck, dumps it off the boards, and clears the zone. 1 minute and 45 seconds gone on the penalty. 14 skates it in for Frederick. 24 looking to get this game even again. Comes in. We're trying to set something up onto the point. Tipped off by Pink. Back into the zone. Goalie does come up, play the puck. Number six picks it up for framework. He's looking for an outlet pass. Pass it off to his teammate. Number 19 has a little bit of speed for the neutral zone. Goes through one, goes through two. Pink looking for a shorthanded break. Number 11 comes in, looking for somebody, takes the skate, goes around the net. Puts the brakes on. Still looking for a teammate. Kramer is in the puck, looking to clear the zone. He is trying to handle the middle zone on the PK. Great PK coming up here. 50 seconds left to go in the penalty. To Kramer. That's your PK. Number 11 grabs the puck, gives it a twist. That's it to the blue line. 24 looking to get in. Passes it to 19. 19 to Kramer. He's looking around, looking to set up a power play now. Set the unit up. Number 8 has the puck on the point. Down low to number 11. 11 over the 19. Looking for the D-man. Out to the point. Just a little bit of the D-man. No. Pink putting some pressure on the neutral zone. 24 takes the skate. He is onside. Passing to 11. 11 across. Goalie's big save. Goalie comes out to play the puck. Headman's a down low. 19 drops it off the top. 17 on the ice. Pink is back to full strength here. Kramer takes it back into the zone. Passes to 19. 19 in the slot. For the backhand. Goalie breaks in and kicks it away. Number 33 comes back to the neutral zone. Looking for somebody to head in the bucket. Passes it off the boards. Number 19. 19 takes the stop. Looks for 17. Pink has the puck in the neutral zone. Gives the puck away. Steals it back again. Number 10. 14 comes in. Taking a look around. Trying to have a look. Looks for 7. Nothing is happening there. Brody Morris takes the puck back into the neutral zone for the save off the stance. And it is...
for a minute.
7 minutes and 50 seconds left to go in the third period. It is 3-0 Pink over Framework. Get that puck. Pink takes the puck. Number 10. Gets tipped up. No call. Pink picks up the puck. Number 7. Walks in. Shoots. Just wide. That line. That paper glass a little bit shorter than the last one he touched. Gets the puck into the net. Framework has the puck. Headbands the puck. No pressure. Breakaway. Number 9 comes in. Down the wing. Gets held up. Still gets a puck. Just one is wide of the net. team trying to clear the zone. 16 jumps to 7. Dances through.
Oh, McCann going to the net.
Great move there. Goalie loses his helmet. Number 7 almost had the goal of the tournament.
Number 7, Devin McCann, former Picton Pirate. He's already had a beautiful goal here, Jam. Third goal of the game, it was unreal, too. So he'd be...
So Devin McCann's got all 3 goals?
No, just the third one.
Just the third one, okay. Picton Pirate.
But it was a really good goal.
That's great. Face off on the left, on the right of Framer's goal. Number 2, I take the draw, 4 feet. Draws it down. 2 giving chase to the corner. Framer's looking to play the zone right now. 51 has the puck on his stick. Quick, intercepted in the neutral zone. Keeps going the other way. Comes into the corner, goes out to 24 Framer. Does slow in. Number 2 takes the puck and shoots it off the side of the net. 51 picks that 4 Framer, dumps it behind the net, reverses it. Nobody home. 7 goes to play the puck. He then takes it back to the neutral zone. A little bit of a rub on there, not too bad. 14 people looking back to the defenseman. Trying to get it back up. Number 2 to number 4. 4 to 4. Pass. Dumps it into the zone. Possible icing. Icing is the call with 5 minutes and 40 seconds left to go in the third. This is a win or go home game. So it looks like somebody's tournament is coming to an end on this great weekend of hockey. Framer takes it, wins the draw. Then dealing with somebody up front. Passes it to no avail. Shoots it, misses wide. Number 8 has the puck. Dumps it down in the corner. 19 plays the puck behind the net. Number 11 has the puck. More Framer gets it to 19. 19 takes it up front to no avail. And D there isn't stopping. Peek takes the puck, fans on the shot, shoots it on net, goalie big save. Goalie lost the puck, number 11 for Peek takes the puck out, looking to get it out of the zone. Kept it by Framer. Peek's still trying to clear the zone, gets it. No ice in there, number 11 gives chase for Peek. Hand pass is the call.
Good pass.
So we will reset, that should go back into the... neutral zone? It is in the neutral zone, just outside the offensive zone.
4:30 left in the third period here, Jim. Distinct Framework needs to put something on the board and quick. They need to get this up to 3-1 and make a late push here. Here they go, 19 hole. Time to the net. They're trying to score one. They need one bad, and they know it.
And as we've seen this weekend, you got one with 4 minutes left. The boys get their legs. You can get a really quick two.
Oh, it's all about momentum in men's hockey. If you get the momentum, you can come back. Oh, down goes Homie in the corner. Former Belleville Bowl, Brody Mortis, a little trip there.
Framer takes the puck out. Oh, it's stopped in the neutral zone by Peek. Peek turns the puck over. Turns it around, steps into the offensive zone. Passes, goal, gets into the corner. 7 minutes to base. 16 has the puck. Framer does get the puck out of the zone. Passes back in. Look at it, headman of the puck. Number 11 comes in, dumps it into the corner. I don't know if the dump and chase system is going to work right now. You're 3 minutes down, you've got to get that puck. And you got to be able to carry it and make a little offense.
In front, Steve, shot.
Oh, doesn't quite make it there. The fence is closing in for Peek under their goalie. I'm trying to make sure that no shot can get through. Puck is going into the zone. Headband up to the front. Number 14 just misses it. Peek looking to turn it around. Gets the puck. But it is picked up by Framer. Framer brings it back to the zone. As they look to regroup here and put a final push on with 3 minutes left. Down by 3. They're going to need a miracle here. But I've seen closer things happen. 17 takes the puck for Framer. Wraps it around the boards. Comes down. Headlines the puck. 12 in on a breakaway. Shoots. Big save by the goalie. Goalie standing tall on the partial breakaway. Possibly save the game before Peek Ridley. If not, we have 2 minutes left of the third period. It will go into stoppage time for every whistle now after the 2-minute warning. the point. Tip it. Trying to pick the puck up. Well, manhandling that thing. Back to the point. 33 has the puck. Takes a look. Takes a shot. Big save. Does it make it to 17? Big save by the goalie. Big looking to clear the zone. One man doesn't have a stick. Icing will be the call. With 2 minutes left. And they are letting the time run because that whistle was after the 2 minute warning.
Yes. 2 minutes.
There's a little bit of disparagement here with the rules of the tournament. They set it back to 2 minutes of stoppage time. Some tells me the goalie is going to be taking a walk pretty soon. Goalie's pulled. Then the extra attacker. And the call is offside. Stopping the clock with 1:46 left to go in the third period. Puck right outside of Peak's defensive zone. Framer in the clock. Goalie's going to come out. Number four just threw it on net. Not knowing the goalie was there. Goalie with the save. Headman's the puck. Goalie's on his way out. Puck's going the other way. Outside the call, boys have to dump in. D-man picks up the puck behind the bench. Cuts it off front, number seven. Four feet gets it over the zone. Framework, number 19, does the right end. Picks up the puck. Minute 16 left to go here in the third period. Trying to get something, trying to break the shutout. 16 takes the puck. Seven tries the shot, bouncing everywhere. Brody Morris clears the puck. And just misses wide. Icing is the call.
BMO going for his cookies here, looking for the first goal of tournaments.
Hey, that's exactly it. Sometimes those are the ones you need to break out for the finals.
He kind of looks like Austin Matthews, Big Pappy down there, just hunting for the empty net goals.
Big Pappy got one this year, and that's exactly what he does. Brody Morris out there looking like a young Shea Weber, just out there ready to bruise and ready for his clap. Brody, great shutdown defense. Played for the last season for the Belleville Bolts. And he misses again. Brody out there, looking like Brian McKay back in the early 2000s, trying to get that 20th goal, just shooting into an empty net and continues to miss.
BMO wants his cookies, ladies and gentlemen. He's looking for them.
Listen, everything is better when you get one goal, especially in a 3-0 lead. It could be 4-0. Basically seal it. 55 seconds left to go. No goal in. And Peak yet again, just taking shots now down towards the end. It's getting a bit comical here that this is continues to happen as they think they can hit the net. But I digress. Here we go. Number 12 takes the faceoff for Framework. Wins the toss. Over 7-6. 33 over. Shoots. Big save by the goalie. 46.1 seconds left to go here in the third period. Winner does go on to the finals of this game for that trip to Vegas. All right, draw coming out here. Number 12 tries to cheat, loses the handle. Bit of a muck there. 19 gets the puck up to the point. 24, 33, looking to shoot. Takes his time. Ready to the goalies. Oh, quick whistle by the ref. On that call, giving the goalie benefit of the doubt. 35.5 seconds left. 3-0 lead over Framework. Framework still desperately trying to get at least one here. 12 brings the draw over to 33. 33 on the point. Shoot. This is wide. Number 9 has the puck. 27 seconds left. Puck is clear. Under the neutral zone. No icing. 11 in the call. 11 gives chase. Framework gets a puck. 17 seconds left to go in the game. Number 9 passes it. Brody Morris into the corner. Brody gets the puck. Clears it. Tipped out by Framework. That will end it. 7 seconds left here. That will be it.
Peak is moving on to the finals, and they will play the winner of the CBY Sully J and the Quinny West Demons. We'll be back with those action shortly.